Another big question is, where did all the iron and silica come from anyway? We think because of the very large size of this deposit, it probably formed in the ocean. So let's think about an oceanic source for the iron and silica. You could either get it off the continents, or you could get it from the deep ocean. Getting it off the continents would not have been easy at these times because there would not have been a lot of weathering. There were no higher plants there to put humic acid into the soil and so on, and to weather the rocks on land to release silica and iron into the oceans. So let's think about an alternative, and that is to get the iron and the silica from the deep ocean. That sort of thing happens now. Hot water comes up in springs on the seafloor. We call them black smokers. It's where seawater circulates through the seafloor and dissolves out all sorts of metals and other things, and those can be released into the ocean. So that's one real possibility, that here we're looking at a situation in the deep ocean where somewhere nearby there were hot springs that were rich in iron and silica, and that was the material that was coming towards the surface and being precipitated when it got somewhere near the surface. I think that's a real possibility. There is some isotopic evidence of that sort of influence in the chemistry of the sediments and the various trace metals and isotopes that are found. So there is some evidence for that. It just makes sense in terms of the alternative of those elements coming from the land. So that's the interpretation that I would favour. And also there is other evidence, and that is that these rocks were later altered into iron ore. We had to get rid of a lot of the silica to make iron ore. And the evidence is that some of that alteration was caused by hot waters flowing through the rocks and dissolving out the silica and leaving behind the iron. So even though it's far from proven, it's a possible way to explain both the source of the iron and silica and the formation of some of the ore. So if the iron was coming from hot springs on the seafloor, it would have been coming out as ferrous iron that was soluble in the water, and there was no oxygen in the deep oceans in those times, and that could have mixed up into the surface layers where the oxygen was being released by photosynthetic organisms, and then the iron would have been precipitated in its ferric form. It doesn't happen now because the oceans are pretty well fully oxygenated, so the iron can't diffuse through the oceans that it would have, in the way that it would have done in earlier times.